Good morning, yesterday. You wake up and time has slipped away, and suddenly it's hard to find the memories you left behind. Remember, do you remember the laughter and the tears, the shadows of misty yesteryears, the good times and the bad you've seen, and all the others in between? Remember, do you remember the times of your life?
College football, it's big crowds, big hits, and big plays. But it wasn't always big time at Fresno State. In 1975, the Bulldogs were playing in a half-empty Ratcliffe Stadium, losing to the Cal State Northridges and Cal Polys of the college football world. The then athletic director, Gene Bordet, sought to change all of that. Enter a coach Bordet had previously hired at Montana State, out of a job after a three-win season at Washington State. That coach, Jim Sweeney.
You knew that they were taking a guy that was really a very good football coach that didn't have the record to back it up, and was going to be now in a situation where he was going to have competitive similarities in the people he was going to deal with, and then he took it to where he did.
So he said, we're moving to California. I said, well, you don't know how good a deal that is.
Sweeney plunged into the new challenge, tirelessly working to, as he called it, awaken a sleeping giant.
You know, it was hard for him because he wanted to recruit high school, but he couldn't do it because of the need to produce right away, and the productivity would have come from junior colleges, so he had to concentrate there. But
results came fast, and in just his second season, Fresno State had a champion, and Jim Sweeney had regained his own professional confidence.
One of the early games we had was in 77 up there in Ratcliffe, and we had 10-1 year here, and I was a coordinator here for Claude at the time, and we had a team that beat Florida State and Arizona. We had a good football team. We went up there and got beat by Dean Jones, quarterback, and it was a great game, but it was in a small stadium. And I thought what Jim had done then in the program was show that there is potential here. Look at the kind of excitement we can create here.
The success fueled the drive to build an on-campus stadium, ending the Ratcliffe days. But when construction began, Jim Sweeney was in the NFL, an assistant coach in 78 with the Raiders and 79 with the Cardinals, before a quirk of fate would bring him back. Fueled by new ideas and driven by a renewed passion, Jim Sweeney put Fresno State on a mercurial rise to staggering heights.
Yeah! Well, those are the greatest! Yeah! I never thought, Dan, you know I'm long-suffering, that I would ever live long enough to see a team that I coach beat USC.
The sixth pick in the first round, and they've selected Trent Dilfer. Yeah!
The program's most prolific years were 1985 to 1991 and saw the team win 79 games and four league championships in that six-year span. And the quarterback, Kevin Sweeney, broke college football's all-time passing record.
And to be able to have the opportunity to play for Jim Sweeney and not only be able to call him dad, but be able to call him coach. And not very many people have that opportunity.
Pro head coaching offers came from the USFL's Arizona Wranglers and the NFL's St. Louis Cardinals. And the builder would be wooed by other college offers near and far. Then in 1992, this one-time Cal Poly fodder made a quantum college football leap, joining the Western Athletic Conference, a league with a history that included a national champion and a Heisman Trophy winner. And the Bulldogs shared the conference crown in each of their first two seasons in the league. Players and colleagues placed the root of this success at Jim Sweeney's passion, a passion and drive that made players and families believers during the often cutthroat recruiting wars.
It made me really see that he really cared about me, and my mom and dad really found out that, you know, he was a real player's coach, so that's why I committed to Fresno State.
Greatest made in my memory, because I had firsthand in it, with when we turned Stephon Page around. And I recruited Stephon out of Saddleback College, and that was my territory, down in Mission Viejo. And he was just a good player, and everybody knew it. And he was going to go to Fullerton. I mean, he had the letter of intent on his desk that he was going to go to Fullerton. And so I stayed with it, and I couldn't close the deal. Coach Sweeney comes down. Within 5 minutes, he has the parents, the sister, Stephon eaten out of his hand.
Fans fawned over the program's NFL products, while families reveled in the changed lives. His players say his passion produced loyalty, desire, and fist-tight team unity.
As a football coach, I mean, he's a great football coach, and I adore it, but the most inspirational thing about Coach that I felt was he helped me off the field. He helped me grow up, because I needed help, you know, when I was coming out of high school, and then I always knew I could turn to him. So, I mean, he helped me more off the field than he did on the field.
It's a four-quarter game!
Four-quarter game!
Well, when I was coming out of high school, I had gotten kicked out of high school, actually. And Coach Sweeney was the only one who allowed me to still come here, and he changed my life totally. When you meet him, and he tells you exactly what he's thinking, where he's coming from, and, you know, you really realize how much he cares for you as a person. And, you know, the football comes secondary with Coach. So, that, you know, that's definitely helped me in my decision to come to Fresno State.
Well, the other day we had a professor from the university came and spoke and said, we as professors can teach the blue chippers and all the blue chippers we think that are grade-A students. But what Jim Sweeney has to do is not always deal with the blue chippers, and he's made great impacts and great men out of people and given them opportunities beyond just football.
As a teacher, clinician, and student of the game, Jim Sweeney drew respect.
And my impression of you, first of all, Danny, is that you know, he's an educator first before he's anything else, and I've appreciated that over the years.
And Jim Sweeney's occasional razzle-dazzle flair is guaranteed to make a game interesting. Now 19 seasons after accepting the challenge, vowing to awaken a sleeping giant, and stepping into uncharted waters, Jim Sweeney steps aside, having turned a Cal Poly and Cal State Northridge loser into a Cal, USC, and Arizona beater. He retires with 200 career wins in tow, a feat achieved by just 16 coaches, 8 league titles in those 19 seasons, and the respect of peers and players alike.
And you look at who Fresno played this year. I mean, Auburn and Oregon and, you know, on that level of people. And we're playing the Oklahomas and Cal's. Well, back then, people would have laughed if we would have scheduled those kind of people. And we're getting closer to being able to play competitively with the quote, majors now.
And when you think about it, I don't think anybody could do that, what he's done. And I don't think you'll see it in the future.
when you can leave your mark as a coach on a particular university in the area that you're responsible for, I think that's quite a credit to him, and that's what he's done.
When we come back, we'll go one-on-one with Jim Sweeney on his 19 seasons as Fresno State's head coach.
I think a leader is given the opportunity to be in the right environment, and then through training presses on the advantage and becomes a leader. Okay, he sees this thing as wealthy. He sees this thing needs somebody to pick it up by the bootstraps. So he says, rise to the occasion, rise to the occasion. And people listen. But he wasn't born to do that. He's just intelligent enough to see no one else is doing it.
When you talk about leadership and the challenges and things, it seems an interesting description of what's happened here at Fresno State. I mean, you had a great challenge and tried to get people to rise. Did you feel when you took on the challenge that you could achieve what you've achieved these 19 years? Did you really believe that this giant could be this big?
I don't know that anybody's that smart. I just feel like there was somebody needed, I use the term, not so much anymore, but I used to use the term a lot. People have copied it, marshal your forces. Got to marshal your forces. The Bob Duncans and the Bud Richters have been able to do that in their own private businesses. But to marshal the forces of a community is a day-by-day, prove it to me, everybody has a destiny. My destiny is fulfilled here at Fresno State. It wasn't long, but wasn't too bad.
Was there a point when you thought, we're going to get this thing turned around, the 77 San Diego State game, or maybe even the 80?
Well, that would never doubt in my mind that I could win when I came here. Mm-hmm. Again, it was a sleeping giant, and somebody had to have the energy, which I was young enough then. I don't have that energy now. Couldn't possibly do that, to marshal the forces, awaken the sleeping giant, and no one man did it. You know, there were a lot of guys, and I'll never forget Lou Eaton and Leon Peters, Bob Duncan, and my good friend Bud Richter, you know, the four guys who wrote the pledge that they would take care of the stadium.
Is the most amazing part of your tenure at Fresno State the fact that you were able to come back after kind of the NFL?
There were a few guys that were shooting cool, you know. There was some formidable resistance. But then when the immovable force met the irresistible force met the immovable object, is that it? Something like that. When they met, clashed, then my friends squeezed up and surfaced out. Four or five of them helped me in. I'll never forget those guys.
Right. Any regrets that maybe the NFL didn't materialize for you the way you'd wanted?
Tiny bit.
Was there any one breakthrough recruit, any guy when you got him, you felt like it was really going to snowball?
Kevin Sweeney looks for Taylor.
But Kevin Sweeney made the difference in this program.
Indeed.
Not Dean Jones. I mean, the stadium builders, that's all fine. Kevin Sweeney filled the stadium. Kevin Sweeney was on ESPN 9 times. Kevin Sweeney made, you know, the short trip, didn't to stay long, but with the Cowboys. Kevin Sweeney played hurt. Kevin Sweeney set the tone for Bulldog football.
You know, we talked to Coach Tolner yesterday, and he was talking about the 77 game.
Oh, yeah?
And he said he said, people don't understand the magnitude of their success over us that year. We've beaten Florida State. We were 10-1. We were a terrific football team. And we get in that little stadium, and it was rocking, and it was packed. And they just kicked the skin off of our ribs. And it seemed like that was kind of an early turning point game. Would you agree with that?
Oh, yeah. I think, you know, if there was one event, I remember, I won't say the name of the graduate assistant, but he came to me and said, your players aren't ready. I said, well, what do you know about getting ready? He said, well, I got it from good hand. Guys on the team, your leadership guys say that people aren't ready. So I went to that old classroom where we were changing in Donata. Oh, those huts down at Radcliffe Stadium. Those kids are getting dressed. We had the shades pulled down. Didn't have showers there or anything. So I go and say, who in the hell is not ready? How could you possibly not be ready? Not ready? I'll be damned if you're not ready. Who's not ready? Kids are all putting their pants up, put their shoulder pads on backwards. It's unbelievable.
Wow.
So what's next for you in the future?
I have no idea. I'm going to come down to San Diego, I think. There's a guy down here that's world famous for treatment of problems, back problems particularly, leg problems, knee problems. I have an old friend who used to be coach with the Rams, Harlan Savari. Mm-hmm. And Harlan and he and this doctor, I don't know if he's a doctor, but he's a physical therapist. So I'm going to come down here for 3 or 4 or 5 days and, you know, see if he can help me get straightened out, because I don't want to be able to run to catch a bus, but I want to be able to jump over the bench, hit the golf ball.
Will life without football be tough?
Yeah, it sure will. For a while. It's going to be a relief, but I'll tell you, it's going to be a... I'll suffer pangs of withdrawal. I know I will.
But the Lion, Bulldog born, Bulldog bred?
You know Blair Holloway, who's a minister and played for us? Mm-hmm. That's the last thing he said at chapel service this morning. He said, you know, Bulldog born, Bulldog bred. Don't think you won't be a Bulldog to the day you're dead, because you will. That one thing sticks in my mind more than anything else. That'll be on my tombstone. You make sure it is.
Okay, that's a deal.
At the mosque.
That's a deal. Up next, the disappointing finale to Jim Sweeney's coaching career.
Got to spend with Jim Sweeney in St. Louis was a wonderful time. It was a great time for me in my career, and I just bonded with Jim. I loved his sense of humor. He was a great coach and just a class act. And Jim, I just want to wish you nothing but the best in whatever life has in store for you now. You deserve it.
We're going to miss you in college football, miss you in football. You've done more for the game than he's ever gotten credit for, and he's truly one of the great coaches, and we're going to miss him. And I'm sure he's going to fly up and watch the Seahawks play and probably correct me a few times in his retirement.
I just think he has a special feelings for people. He knows how to deal with people. He's a great motivator. It's fun to have some character, and especially to be led by a great leader like him. And
loses Jim Sweeney after tomorrow night. What does it lose?
Well, I think it loses, from my perspective, one of the unique and very successful people. And I think unique in that he's always said what's on his mind. Obviously, to win 200 games makes you unique, because there's not that many in the profession that have ever done that. So from a winning standpoint, he is. But also from just his personality and character and what he's meant to the young people.
He talked of awakening a sleeping giant, and inspiration. Fresno State has enjoyed unparalleled success during his tenure, with 143 wins, 8 conference titles, and 5 total championships to his credit. The contributions to the University of Tennessee far exceed what they could have for championship titles. Your head football coach, the Longview Seminoles. Yeah.